Here we go. You're taking a chance with me, and you've got me panicking. I feel like I'm losing it when I see your history. I don't know what to think. I can't break the habit, can't live without it. I'm craving something I don't have. At first time it's magic, but the fact is you're gone when I turn my back. And now I'm following a laugh track in a plastic conversation, 'cause they're jealous of what I have. But I don't wanna be a part of it. I wanna love you more than half the time. I wanna have it, but it isn't right. I would do anything, but I crashed my car 'cause I was trying to impress you. But you're just not that into me. Just not that into me. I can't break the habit, can't live without it. I'm craving something I don't have. And now I'm following a laugh track in a plastic conversation, 'cause they're jealous of what I have. But I don't wanna be a part of it. I wanna love you more than half the time. I wanna have it, but it isn't right. I wanna love you more than half the time. I wanna have it, but it isn't right. And I'm getting what I wanted. I'm selling out my soul. And if it falls to pieces, well, at least you'll get a show. I wanna love you more than half the time. I wanna have it till it isn't right. Thank you so much. Glad that one's out of the way. So what I'd love to do as an artist and with a project is to build a kind of like team together. I'd love for this to be something that builds and kind of we grow together. And someone who I've absolutely loved having in a small part of this has been little boy Ellis here. We first met when we were in school together. I played in Jaurès and he played little Gavroche in Les Mis. And he's still in school, but he's an insanely talented guitarist and an insanely talented musician. And I'd love for him to kind of build up with me. It's kind of convenient that his name's Ellis, because Ben Ellis. But I wanted to show you guys how talented this guy is. So we're going to do a song. Ellis is going to get up and sing. Do you want to do the guitar bit at the beginning, or are you just going to put it down? No, put it down. Okay, cool. And yeah, this is going to be super fun. This song's called Pool House. It's by the Backseat Lovers. I hope you enjoy it.
Damn, this is scary, man.
Waiting around for something to change my mood, 'cause I know that what's in these plastic cups isn't going to. Kids on the lawn stuck in pairs of two. Your lunch is on its way back up, but you're still in the pool. I'll be fine. I guess I'll sit outside while you change your mind. Oh no. Oh. risk it all to find a place where I can hear my thoughts. This song's playing too loud, but upstairs they're still making out, getting all choked up. I guess it's just my luck, and I'm stuck on the porch. What am I waiting for? Wait inside. I'll be fine. I guess I'll sit outside while you change your.
Give it up for Ellis, man. Jeez. That was sick. This is one of my favorite songs. I don't know the lyrics to, kind of, but we're going to just wing it. This is one of those songs that you kind of can wing. And yeah, just double checking what key we're in. This song's called Sweet Disposition.
Oh, cry. Our eyes are on some moment of love, a dream, a lie. A moment of love, a dream, a lie. Just living. Cause I'll be coming over.
Sick. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Okay, cool.
I'm going to do a few songs on my own. But yeah, thanks guys. Appreciate it. They're not gone. They're coming back. So good. I just want to give a second now just to say a huge, huge thank you, like, to you guys for coming, to like everyone who's played, to Greg Ryan, who is absolutely amazing. Thank you so much. I met Greg at open mic quite recently, and I was like, hey, do you want to play a gig at a house? And he came. And then Jack, we're in the hallway at Ed's house party, and he was like, hey man, I do music too. And I was like really drunk, and I was like, oh, really? But yeah, it's mad that now we've come to this point and doing something like this. Aidan, one of my best mates from school, one of my favorite lyricists of all time. I think he's ridiculously talented and just amazing. So I'm very grateful to him. I'm trying to make sure I go in order. Tom, who I met at c-bloc doing that. Mad, you're crazy, like incredible guitarist. Natty, and we met at Michael Aldag. We did a support act for Michael, and I'm so glad that I got to meet you. You're incredible and so amazing. And Inner Voices, James as well. Specifically who I've become to be really good friends with. We were in sex education together, that's where we met. Not in the show, we were extras, not that talented. But yeah, so glad that I got connected to you and Inner Voices and stuff. So thank you to all of you, you're all incredible, amazing artists. I don't know what my next song is. Okay. So I recently went to Los Angeles. And it was the best thing ever. I loved it. Being there and meeting people who were doing the same thing as me and feeling like you weren't an idiot in that kind of sense was insane. But there was kind of I went through a weird process of not really knowing what I want from the next stage, the next year. And it kind of felt like I've got like two paths that I could go on. And it really scared me. So on the last day, I had a session with three of my really good friends and wrote this song. And yeah, I hope you enjoy it. It's called No One Sleeps in Hollywood. Dramatic effect.
Forgot the lyric.
I'm in a conflict with the irony. I've tried to do it by myself, but there's no I in team. And all my problems feel like a lousy apology. And every person standing several steps in front of me. I try to catch it, but the journey doesn't feel like it's worth it. And there's another road in my mind that just looks like it's perfect. But I'm too reckless and I barely sleep. I guess that's irony. I've been told no one sleeps in Hollywood. Everything doesn't feel like it should. I've got so much left to sacrifice. Is all the pain a way to make me find some paradise? If I didn't want this in my life, it would be easy. Get a little comfy, close my eyes, and then I'm 50. But I've been told no one sleeps in Hollywood. Everything doesn't feel like it should. And I've been drinking dreams as if it's whiskey, but it's bitter now. They just chew you up for something sweet and then they spit you out. I've been told no one sleeps in Hollywood. And I tell myself they'll miss me, but I can't seem to remember how. Kicking double meanings like I'm looking for a little doubt. I've been told no one sleeps in Hollywood. Who is the person I live up to? Says he's gonna do all of these things, but then they fall through. Either I'm a sellout or a burnout, but that's up to you. In a couple years, am I still playing shows in my bedroom? Cause I've been told no one sleeps in Hollywood. Everything doesn't feel like it should. And I've been drinking dreams as if it's whiskey, but it's bitter now. They just chew you up for something sweet and then they spit you out. I've been told no one sleeps in Hollywood. And I tell myself they'll miss me, but I can't seem to remember how. Taking double meanings like I'm looking for a little doubt. I've been told no one sleeps in Hollywood. Until I'm running on a risk, as long as someone listens. Printed on my wrist, I'll honor the commitment. And I'm getting in my way, and maybe there's no way I'll live another day. I'll take my thoughts to bed now. I've been told no one sleeps in Hollywood. I've been told no one sleeps in Hollywood. I've been told no one sleeps in Hollywood. No one sleeps in Hollywood.
Thank you so much. Cheers. This is one of my favorite songs ever written. Just need to remember the chords. It's called I Don't Want to Be Okay by Charlie Bird. I don't want to be okay without you. It's a long name. Gets confusing.
You're saying things I don't believe. And your love casts its shadow on the things I do. And I can hear so clearly all the words I wish I'd said. You stuck in my head. But I only think of you. Will we be together soon? I'm thrown to the wayside. You're planted in my mind. But I don't wanna be okay without you. Now I can't find the words to say that'll be the perfect balance between loud and clear. And I can hear so well your lovely voice inside my head saying you love me. But I only think you're will we be together soon? I'm thrown to the wayside. You planted it in my mind, but I don't wanna be okay without you.
So much. Cheers. A little while ago, my best little pal, Aidan, asked me to do a song with him, and it's probably my favorite song that I've ever released. From a sense of just, there's no pressure. We would just like put it out, and then we sat as spoons, and just had a nice chat and just chilled, and it was just the most amazing little thing. So I'm very grateful to him for letting me do that with him. I think he's an incredible artist, and I would love to welcome Aidan up to sing with me on this song. Yeah. You can play, because I forgot the chords. Would I be able to grab a mic? Would that be okay?
Oh, sound. Thank you.
One, two. Is that good? I hate singing without a guitar. Like, how do you?
Okay,
we'll just do it. This song's called Night Shift. It's off Aidan's album, Was Here, and
is that right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think
so. I wrote the thing or anything.
Yeah. I think I'll just sit down for this bit because it's you.
I'm not a singer, I just play one in your ear. It's not that I don't like you, I've just had a nightmare of a year. I don't believe in soulmates, there's too little in the soul that I like. But something must be desperately wrong if everything is alright. If what she tried to say was predictable, what she said was nothing short of banal. Eyes and ears and bug drones, I'll take any excuse to play foul. You and me were working on the night shift, scurried off, and now I'm fucking homesick for that bleak and habitual 9 to 5. Me and you got kicked when they shake us. Daft smiles when for lovers they mistake us. Strapped up shins, we're gagging for some overtime. And it's nothing like you to kiss clowns for someone like me.
That was so pointless. Why was I sat down?
I'm not half bad at catching, but I just can't seem to throw. My heart was racing, but my mouth was slow. The teeth of tomorrow's regret stuck into me like gently and quick. Explain it to me as if I was 5, cause I just can't get it to click. And what she tried to say was awful, and what she said was salt in the wound. eyes and ears and bug drones that take any excuse to come through. You and me were working on the night shift, scurried off, and now I'm fucking homesick for that bleak and habitual 9 to 5. Me and you got kicks the way they shake us. Stop smiles when for lovers they mistake us. Strapped up shins, we're begging for some overtime. And it's nothing like you. Two kids clowns for someone like me. You don't, but I miss the Larkins. You don't, but I miss the boss man. You don't, but I miss the broken clock. And you don't, but I miss the local. You don't, but I miss the Larkins. You don't, but I miss the boss man. You don't, but I miss the broken clock. And you don't, but I miss the walk home.
Aidan Cross, everyone. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
This song, I flew to Bulgaria, got matching tattoos with strangers. Flew back, Finn was like, hey, let's go do a music video. And we were like, yeah, sure. So we flew back again to Bulgaria, got matching tattoos, had a really great video moment, went on Bulgarian television. It was, that's kind of it. The song's called Sofia. I hope you enjoy it.
Quarter to 9 and nobody's sober. I should've left like an hour ago. I caught her eye, now she's calling me over. I'm in a room with nobody I know. I wish this didn't have to end, but odds are we'll never meet again. Sophia says she's got a bad idea. I got a way that we can stay right here. We might regret it, but there's nothing to lose. Just two perfect strangers getting matching tattoos. A drop of ink really shouldn't be lethal. She said she's seen someone do it before. I'm getting skittish, she's getting a needle. Just make it small, something we can ignore. I wish this didn't have to end, but odds are we'll never meet again. Sophia says she's got a bad idea. I got a way to stay right here. We might regret it, but there's nothing to lose. Just two perfect strangers getting matching tattoos. She's got a bad idea. I got a way to stay right here. We might regret it, but there's nothing to lose. Just two perfect strangers getting matching tattoos. Sophia says she's got a bad idea. I got a way to stay right here. We might regret it, but there's nothing to lose. Just two perfect strangers getting matching tattoos. Thank you so much. Cheers.
All right, it's the big one. Can I just have Jack and Ellis back one more time? Come on, boys, up you come. So, this is my last song. This is a song I wrote about my best friend and the house parties we used to do in a specific house. It's this house. This is mad. This is weird. I feel like this is going to be such a weird moment. But anyways, I wrote this song. It's about my friend Ed and this house, specifically this house. I feel like I've just said that. Yeah, thank you so much for coming down. I appreciate it. I know it's been a bit later than expected, but you guys are the best, and I really appreciate it. Thank you so much to Helen. Amazing. Ed's mum. She's let us throw 3 parties, 1 music video, and now 1 gig. and then another gig later on in the year. Thanks, Helen, appreciate it. And then, yeah, it's I'm just very grateful to you. Thank you so much. You are the best, bestest ever. Thank you. And yeah, I'm very grateful to you guys for coming. This song's called Ed's House. I hope you enjoy. Where are you going? There's a party at its house. We stole some liquor from our parents who drink too much. We always dreamed about the night we could get out. This is the moment we forget everything. And I know it may seem crazy, but you're all that I need. Just dance with me together till a quarter to three. I don't see all of these faces when it's just you and me, so don't play teenage the bag on repeat. Cause we don't know what to do at 17. Let's start thinking about tomorrow. Now we got out. Cause we are at a party at Ed's house. Yeah. And now I'm chasing someone I just can't work out. You're always distant now, we're kissing around the block. It's in the open and I'm thinking about how after tonight it won't get better than this. And I swear it's like a moment in a movie scene. And I watched it thinking this could never happen to me. But I'm never gonna turn it off, I'm living a dream. So we'll play teenage the bag on repeat. Cause we don't know what to do at 17. Let's start thinking about tomorrow. Now we got out. Cause we are at a party at Ed's house. And when everybody's leaving till it's just you and me, going back and forth on life until a quarter to three. Feels like nothing else can matter when you're taking the lead. Okay, right. We're in Ed's house. So I require everyone to say Ed's house when we get to that bit. I mean, if you don't know the lyrics, that's fine. But if you do know the whole lyrics, get it out. I mean, we've just sung a little bit. So voices are warm. But if you guys could sing a little bit of Ed's house when we get to that chorus, it's pretty easy. Okay, here we go. We're gonna build it. And then Ellis. It's my band, guys.
We'll play teenage the bag on repeat. Cause we don't know what to do at 17. Let's start thinking about tomorrow. Now we got out. Cause we are at a party at
oh wow.
Off my t-shirt in the sink, and I don't think I remember anything. We're still thinking about tomorrow, but we got out when we were at a party at
Ed's house. Wow, wholesome. Thanks, guys, appreciate it. Thank you. Thanks again to c-bloc, Will, Finn, Tom, you're all insane. I love you so much. And yeah, all of you for coming down. Appreciate it. Yeah, thanks, guys.